Hello everyone, you're welcome to this week's Tech Tuesdays webinar on Intelligent Structure Discovery in CDI Implementation and Use Cases. I'm Rinda, your host for today's session. And we have Nalin Yadav, Solution Architect from the Customer Success team as a presenter for today's session. Before we start this webinar, let's go through some housekeeping tips. The duration of the webinar is 1 hour, that includes a 15 minutes Q&A. You can post your queries in the Q&A box. Dial-in participants are muted for the session. The session is being recorded. The recording will be available in the Informatica Support YouTube channel and the Success Portal. You'll also be able to download the slide deck from the Success Portal. Please feel free to put in your feedbacks and suggestions for the session in the post-webinar survey. The Tech Tuesdays webinars are hosted within the Success Portal, which is a microlearning platform that offers free and unlimited learning to all registered users. This feature-rich platform was launched to help you learn and use Informatica products better. Here are a few important links that you can go over later that will help you in your product adoption journey with Informatica. Over to you, Nalin. Thank you.
Thanks for the introduction. Topic for today's session is ICS, Intelligent Structure Discovery, or ISD component. And as part of this session, we are primarily talking about ISD implementation and use cases. The overall agenda for this session is we'll be talking about primarily first on the introduction on the ISD, and then we'll be talking about the intelligent structure model, and I will be explaining how we can create ISM by using few of the sample files. And also, we'll be talking about how the intelligent structure discovery process works in Informatica. And also, I'll be touching a few other aspects like benefits of the ISD components, the use cases example, the mapping compatibility, what is data drift and unassigned data in ISD. And also, I will be talking about refining of the intelligent structure model. And then this session will be followed by a few of the demonstration. And in the last, we'll be covering the Q&A session for this webinar. So let's go first for the introduction of the ISD. Intelligent Structure Discovery, or ISD, is one of the Informatica component which automates file ingestion processing, and it is powered by Informatica CLAIRE AI engine, discover and parse the complex files. ISD help us to determine the underlying pattern and structure of the input data which we provide to create the model, and also we can use this model to transform, parse and generate the output groups. As of now, ISD component provide support for various data formats. For an example, it does provide support for IoT log files, CSV files, text delimited files, XML, JSON and few other formats. So as and when we are dealing with unstructured, semi-structured or non-structured file formats in any of your integration implementation use case, we can definitely can give a thought for the ISD implementation, because it will help us to easily understand and parse the complex data file format in Informatica. And ISD also comes handy as and when we are dealing with complex file which is having very little structure or very difficult to parse in the implementation perspective. And internally, Informatica ISD components automatically decipher the input data, and it determines the or it and then it will determine the patterns, the repetitions and the relationships and the types of the data, whatever they're in the sample file or the model file which will be feeding it to the ISD component. After the Informatica Intelligent Structure Discovery component discovers the structure of the data, we can there's a possibility we can refine the structure model created by this component. There are various properties which we can leverage, and the model which is created by ISD is called as ISM, or the Intelligent Structure Model, which is stored in terms of .a model file, and primarily it will go to the Informatica host or the Informatica repository. But again, if there is a ask if you want to see how this A model file looks in the real time, you can export this component from the Informatica UI, and then you can directly see how it looks behind the scenes. So if you see from the introduction perspective, ISD provides ISD comes with few of the machine learning capability to discover and parse the complex files in the integration implementations. It also simplify complex business processes, which is when we are dealing with complex file structure, like considering the log files or the very complex JSON or the very complex XML file. So it will help us to simplify the complex business integrations in the integration platform of any of the organization. Now, from the performance perspective, it does provide support to advanced partitioning as well as the pushdown optimization. Now coming to the implementation, so from the Informatica UI, if we need to create any inter-instructure discovery component, we need to go to ISM model tab like this. The moment we'll hit this tab, a new window will open. There we need to provide the sample data file. The moment discovery phase start, at the end it will generate the And in the end, it will generate the visual model of the sample data, visual model from the sample data. Now, coming to the interior structure model, what is interior structure model in IACS? So ISM is an asset in IACS, which interior structure discovery creates based on the input data which we provide, which will help to pass the data at the runtime. Also, ISD creates a model that expresses the expected output data. We can use this model in mapping to pass unstructured, semi-structured, and the structured data. As I already mentioned, like what all different types we can leverage to build ISM or the interior structure model in Informatica. These are the various file format which we can use to build ISM in IACS. Now, coming to the model, how ISM will be created in Informatica. So considering this example, I have one CSV file as an input in inform. I am considering this CSV file as an input file which I am feeding to ISD, and this CSV file is having some information like first name, last name, street, city, and state and zip. And the moment I will feed this information to ISD, ISD automatically will create the visual model like this. There will be a root node, say table, because it's coming as a CSV data, so it consider that the data as a tabular format, and on top of that it will create the master node or the root node as address. And we are not telling ISD this is the address data or this is a person related data. All the ML AI capability behind the scene for ISD are leveraging to build this visual model, and it automatically identified what all data is coming from the sample file. So if you see from this data set, this model has been created, and we can simply see it created the root node as table, and under that there is a node for address. And also we can see there are two different child node created under the full name node. So this is how interior structure model will be created in Informatica, and we just need to provide the file and rest of the things will be taken care by ISD. To build an the same thing which I explained just few minutes back, to create an interior structure model in Informatica, you need to go to the component tab, click on the interior structure UI, then the new window will open, and then as part of the creation process, we need to provide one of the sample file in the schema sample file place. The moment we'll click on the discovery structure, the parsing of the sample file will start, and a visual model will be created on top of this data set. So this is how we'll be creating ISM in Informatica. Now coming to the refining or modifying the created model in Informatica. So suppose in one of the scenario, you already built one Informatica, one of the interior structure model in IACS, and on top of that, you want to add few more properties. For example, you want to rename few of the nodes, you want to exclude few of the nodes. So in that scenario, you want to select any node as a parent node. So that sort of changes or that sort of refining you can achieve by following the refining process. And All the relevant options for a particular node will be opened the moment you will hit a right click on that particular node. And few of the options will not be applicable for all the nodes, because ultimately whatever properties we are trying to configure, it is highly dependent on the data which we use to create this model. So by using these properties, we can refine this model, and we can make it in line to our ultimate requirement, which we are planning to push into production. So if you will see this data out of this JSON file, this model has the visual model will be created like this, and at the same time, corresponding to this JSON model, the relational output looks like this. Now, how we can leverage ISD in Informatica mapping? So for that, we need to create one mapping in Informatica in which we'll be connecting to one of the source endpoint, and in the intermediate transformation, we'll be leveraging structure parser transformation, which internally uses ISD component to pass the input data, and also whatever output groups we have configured while creation of the intelligent structure model, those output group will also be part of the structure parser transformation, which will be mapping to the endpoint targets in my mapping. So if you'll see, the moment I have selected the source transformation, then there is a structure transformation, and at the structure parser transformation, if you'll see, I will be attaching this structure parser transformation to one of the intelligent structure discovery component, and also I am defining what kind of output I am expecting from this transformation. So for example, I am selecting relational here, and the moment we'll select the relational here, there will be corresponding output port or the output fields will be created in the output field tab, and these output fields will come in the pipeline from the ISM model which we have created in the previous step. So this is how we'll be implementing ISD component in any of the mapping. So basically, ISD won't be able to use standalone in the mapping. Basically, you need to go via structure parser transformation route. Now coming to the ISD process. So ISD process consists of the very first step to provide the input data. So the moment we provide the input file, and ISD determines the underlying data, and then it will identify what all repeating patterns we have in the sample data, and on top of that, it will create the visual model. It will consider what are the repeating groups we have in the sample data, what are the relationships we have in the sample file. So all those pointers will be discovered by ISD component, and according to it, it will create the visual model. And these models we can use to pass any of the complex data, considering if it is coming from a log file, if it is coming from any of the sensor file, sensor related data, or if it is coming from any of the clickstream data or the customer web access data. So ultimately, whatever sample data we are feeding to intelligent structure discovery, automatically it will identify the various pattern in it. It will identify what all groups this particular data set contains in the file, what are the different relationships it has. So according to it, it will create the visual model in the end. Now, coming to the benefits and the use case and in the uses and the real implementation. So if you see from the benefits perspective, it leverages AI and the machine learning capability, which help us to auto generate visual models, which is very easy and very, very handy to understand from the understanding perspective. And also it helps, or it empowers teams to be more agile with machine data through advanced tool that assists through Informatica. Also, it easily put auto-generated parser for machine data and other log files to work in Informatica Intelligent Cloud Services. It also leverages high-performance loading capability, because it supports advanced partitioning and the push-down optimization. Coming to the usage, different scenario where we can leverage ISD component. So the very first usage is as and when we are dealing with any of the long or very complex file which is having very little structure, or there are no structure, there is no uniform structure throughout the file data. And also it automatically, the capability which I already explained in the previous slides, it automatically decipher the input data where by using MLA capability to discover the different patterns and the relationships and the types of the data in any of the file. So as and when we are dealing with any of the data set where the format of the data is not fixed and it is highly unstructured and it is highly complex to understand, so in those scenario we can look for the ISD implementation. And if in summary, if it asks me, we can prefer ISD implementation as and when we are dealing with any of data format like unstructured, semi-structured, or the structure. Coming to the use case example, so if you see, I created this model by referring this input data. If you see closely this data set, there are two, this is XML data set in which I have two different employee ID 100 and employee ID 101. In this example, if you see for employee ID 100, there is no manager ID specified in the sample data, but at the same time, manager ID is specified for the second record. So the moment I will feed this data to ISD, though this data set is inconsistent in nature, ISD will create the model more correctly, because you can see the generated model will have the manager ID in the visual model, or basically manager ID is one of the node in the model. So though your input data is inconsistent in nature, ISD considered or parses this data set more efficiently, and it generated the most suitable structure out of it. Now coming to the compatibility from the mapping perspective, so we can leverage ISD component in CDI mapping. We can also leverage ISD mapping in CDI elastic mapping. We can also use them in data engineering mapping as well as in B2B gateway. Now coming to the data drifts and the unsigned data set. So for an example, let's first talk about what is data drift. So suppose if I have this sample data in which I've used to create the entire structure model in an IICS, and it will have a certain data set in it. It's a pipe delimited data set, and it has say 5 or 6 columns in the sample data. But at the same time, the moment the actual integration runs, we receive this sort of data in which we have few additional columns. So in this scenario, though we are getting additional field in the input data, ISD component will pass this data set more efficiently, and it will pass all this additional information from this file to an assigned group. So though your model created on a different data set, your actual processing data set is different, there shouldn't be any challenge, because ISD component will be able to pass this sort of data set more correctly. Now coming to the unassigned data set. So unassigned data set will come into picture when there are two scenarios. So one scenario is when there is when the maximum record size exceeds from the memory perspective. So as of now, if you see, the default maximum record size is 640K in bytes. And if you want to further increase this property in Informatica, you can set up one DTM JVM property of the runtime environment in your secure agent or the IAC admin console. And that is one of the scenario where unassigned data will come into picture. And at the same time, for example, if you have created a sample, if you have created IS model or intelligent structure model by considering this data set in which you have few columns, 5 or 6 column in the sample data, at the same time in your input file, if you have more than expected column. So in this scenario also, whatever newly added or the additional columns are coming in the input file, all this data will go to the unassigned group. So these are the two things which Informatica ISD component manages automatically. And this unassigned data is a runtime property. It's not like you need to configure additionally. It's a runtime property which is supported by ISD itself. Now, coming to the pointers where we'll be refining the structure. So as I told, right, at the moment you supply the sample file for the model creation, and on top of it, if you want to add few properties, for example, you want to rename few nodes, you want to change the root node from the model, you want to build foreign key, parent key, primary key and the foreign key relationships in the data set. So if you want to leverage that sort of properties in your model, you can follow this process. Just supply the test file to your model, discover the structure, then test the output. At the moment you think the output is as expected and it's ready to propagate to your production, then we are good. If it is not, then you need to go back to the previous step, modify the model, then feed the sample file, sample data file again to test the output. And just, it's an iterative approach which you need to follow according to your need. So far we are done from the explanation of the ISD component. Let's now go to the demonstration part of this session. So as part of demonstration one, what I will be doing is I will be creating different ISM models in Informatica cloud by referring XML, JSON and different files. So let's consider the very first example in which I will be creating one ISM using the XML file, and all the refining properties I will be explaining by this demonstration. So for an example, I would say this is my demo one. And now I will go and select one of the sample file which is there for the employee data. So I just selected the model employee XML file which I just referred in a few minutes back, in which the manager ID is missing in one of the record, but it is present in another record. So if you'll see, the moment I will click on the discover structure button, the visual model has been created in the UI page, and the moment I will click on the relational output, I can see what relational output this model will be giving as an output. The moment I will feed this, I will feed any data to this component, this is how the output group will be generated. Now if you see few more properties here. So suppose, as I told, right, if I need to change any of the property from the model, for an example, if I need to rename the first name field, I can simply go and rename it to F name. Similarly, if I don't want to propagate phone number root, phone number node in my downstream pipeline, so I can simply exclude this from the structure. So if you see, this became F name and phone number removed from the output group. At the same time, if you want to add the document ID, so basically document ID is one of the identifier in the ISM properties, which talks about what all with the particular record or the particular transaction is during the runtime, that particular transaction is coming from the same input source or any other input source. So suppose if you are pushing or if you are loading multiple files through your mapping in Informatica, so you ultimately wanted to understand where this particular transaction in my output file came from the same source or not. So that sort of capability we can leverage by enabling the document ID property. The moment I will enable the document ID on the root node, the additional column will be created in the output group, which is data record document ID. So it follows the same pattern. So the root name underscore document ID, that key will be created in the output group. And at the same time, if I need to change root node of this structure, so suppose by any chance, if I need to make f name as the root node. So I can make it as root node. So there will be direct so basically all these changes are highly aligned with your sample data set. So there might be chances if you are making this root node, then ultimate there shouldn't be any sense you will make it then there shouldn't be any chance that there shouldn't be any sense you will be getting from the data. But yeah, if your data supports that sort of capability from the structure, then definitely you can leverage these all refining properties in the model. And also at the same time, if your model does support if your sample data having a nested group in the in it, then you will be able to create the PKFK relationship within your model, which I will show you in a minute. So for an example, so this is the very very simple use case in which I am using a XML file and ISD created visual model on top of it. And though there is a missing field in the data set, the model the accurate model has been created. So this is the one thing. Now considering to the second scenario in which I am pushing the JSON file. So the same process I will be following again. I will be selecting the JSON file this time, and the moment I will click on the discover structure, then it will create the visual model here, and whatever properties I have explained from the refining perspective, those are again applicable. The only big the only property if you see from here, just give me a second. So this is how we can build a structure out of the JSON data set. Now let me show you the FK PK relationship, how we can build in ISD. So let me select one of the data in which I have a nested group. The moment I have selected this PKFK sample data, ISD is able to pass this data set, and inside to this data set you can see department ID. Department is one of the root node. Department is one of the node in which we have a employees node, and at the same time we will be having another employee node in it, which is primarily talking about employee name and the employee ID. Let me show you how this data looks in the file. So this is my company ID. And inside this company ID, I have a domain, then I have an employee name like this, and then I will be having again domain for accounting and another employee name. So I will be having a nesting groups in this sample file. So for this data set, I can see I can leverage a PK-FK relationship. To enforce a PK and FK thing in the model, what I have to do is I need to promote this group to the main group, and the moment I will click on this button, two additional keys will be created in the output group, which is department item underscore PK and at the same time department item FK. It is created for the department item on the basis of department item. Reason being, as of now in my model, department ID is the or the department item is the record ID. But for an example, in your use case or in your sample, if you have any other key which you want to make it as a primary key, what you have to select is then what you have to do is just click on that particular field, and then if that field is applicable to make the primary key in the model, you will be able to see this option select as record ID. And the moment you will select this record ID, your PK and FK will change accordingly. So this is how we can enforce a PK FK in the ISM model. Now the very widely used questions I have seen so far is how we can build ISM or the IS model or the intelligent structure model using XST file. So for that, we need to follow two-step process. In step one, we need to provide the XST file to the ISD component, and it will, and at, in the secondary, and as part of the step two, we need to provide the XML sample file like this. And the moment I will click on the relational output, it will show you the tabular output from the XML source. So just considering the XSD source, there will be a two-step process to build the entire instruction model in Informatica. So the moment you will click on save button, this model will be created and it will be saved in the Informatica repository. And then we can use this model in Informatica mapping to build the ETL pipeline. This concludes the IS or the entire instruction model creation demonstration. As part of the demonstration too, I will be explaining another use case. So let me show you the files first, what I am processing as part of the demo one. So this is the file. Again, I am referring the same file again, in which I have two employee ID. One employee ID has the manager ID and another one is not having manager ID in the data set. So this is the sample file which I have used to create the model in ISD. And then this is my actual data file in which I will be having data which I need to process through my ETL pipeline. So this is one of the file which I will be loading, and in the similar format I have another file, data employee2.xml. This file I am also loading through my ETL pipeline. And to load these files at the same time, I created one file list file in this format, in which I will be providing the absolute path for the data files. And then I will use this file list in my source transformation to read data, basically to read data from these two files. So if I will go to, I already created one mapping to implement this use case, and I forgot to mention the one of the crucial thing. If you see in my actual data files, I have added one additional column, say which is named as new column. If you see, this new column field is not there in the model data. So what will happen? Though my sample data is inconsistent, my IS model will be created with having manager ID in it. At the same time, the moment I will load these two files, there is one additional column will come in pipeline. And then, as I spoke, right, this any new column which is not there in your model will go to the unassigned group of the ISD. So let's see how it works in mapping. So I already created ISD for this model, and also I have enabled that document ID property, because here I am loading two files at one go. So I just want to understand which all record came from the same input source. So I already enabled this property in the model structure. Now if I will go to the mapping, so if you'll see in this mapping, I am reading data from that file list which I have just shown you. And in the structure parser transformation I have used in the intermediary transformation in the pipeline, which is pointing to the model which I have just created on to pass this employee data. And the output I have mentioned as relational for this data set. And if you'll see, I map the corresponding field in my transformation, and at the output field, if you see, there are two groups created. One is an identified group and another one is data record group. So if you see in data record group, have all the columns which is coming from the file. Here we have manager ID, and at the same time we'll be having a data record document ID. Then I have two target endpoints. One is for the identified data and another one is for the unidentified data. So let me place these files in the source directory, and then I will execute this mapping. So to execute this mapping, I already built an mapping configuration task. So this is my mapping configuration task which I have built on this mapping, and let me run this mapping. Let's see how it looks, how the data looks post the completion of this job. So it will take some time to complete. So MCT job is completed. Let me see how my target files looks like with regards to this data set. So if you see, I have 10 records. If you see my employee file one here, I have 5 records, and at the same time I have 5 records in the file two. So all 10 records came into one of the file, and I have added one additional column, data record document ID, which is same for first for 5 records out of 10, and similarly this ID is same for another 5 records. So this document ID is primarily talking this particular these many particular records came from the same input file, and similarly these 5 group these 5 records came from the same input group. Now if you see in the unidentified file, the new column which is not there in the model, it got created in the unidentified file, and the corresponding values are also being loaded in this file. So in this scenario, we can easily understand how ISD works. If your data model is created on a different set of file and you are processing different set of files in your ETL pipelines. So this concludes the demo for this particular use case. As part of the next demonstration, I will be talking about the FK and PK implementation in ISM. For that, let me show you the data set which I have there in place. So if you see from the data, this is so I've used this part from this file to build the entire structure model, and this file and to process an additional data on top of that model, I created this data file. So if you see here, we have multiple records and I will be processing these records. So if let me show you the ISD model for it. If I will go to the demo to ISD here, I have enabled all those properties with regards to the PK and FK. I propagated that employee group to the main group, and because of which the PK and FK created on the department ID, and the department ID is created in the item group, and employee and the foreign key is created in the employee group. So if you want me to show from the ISM perspective, so here I enabled this property. Just give me a sec. So here if you see, I have enabled this property join to parent group and promote to group. So here earlier that promote to group option was coming, so I enabled that property here, and then because of which I was able to see PK and FK in my output groups. So considering this ISM, I created another mapping in which I am reading data again from the file like this. This is the file in which through which I am reading data from my source transformation, which is pointing to the file which I have just shown you. And in the intermediary transformation, I am using again the structured parser transformation, which is pointing to my ISD TT demo to ISM model. For this also, I kept my output format as relational. In the output group, you can see three different groups being created, one for item and another one for employee, and we have a department ID as department item PK here in the parent group, and the department item fk key in the child group. And corresponding to this model, I have assigned three target endpoints. So department item will go to the first target, the employee data will go to the second target, and unidentified data will go to the third target. So let me execute this mapping and then I will show you the output from the output files. To execute this mapping, I already created MCT, so I'm just executing this MCT now, and let's see how data looks in the output file. Will take few more minutes and then we'll see the data files. So output files got created. I believe this MCT run completed. So let me show you data in the output file. So let first inspect what is there in unidentified CSV. So there is no unidentified data has been found in my data file. My data file is 100% in line with the model which I have used, which I've created in ISD. So that's why there is no unidentified data in in this file. Now if I will go to the parent file, so all the parent information came to this parent file, and if you see the child data, right, let me copy it from here to this place so that I can show you this particular transaction from your child record is associated with this parent record, and similarly this child record is associated with this parent record. So this is how we can enforce a parent child relationship in the output groups as and when we are dealing with semi-structured or very complex structure set of data. So that's all concludes all three. So that's what I have thought to cover as part of the demonstration three. I think we are good to proceed for the so we are good for the Q&A session now. Thanks everyone.
Hello everyone, if you have any queries or doubts, please post them in the Q&A box. The presenter and the panelists will answer you. Over to you, Nalin. Before we jump into the questions, I just wanted to call out that the sessions, all the Tech Tuesday sessions are being recorded and will be available in the Informatica Support YouTube channel and the Success Portal. You'll be able to download the slide deck from the Success Portal. Also, after the end of the session, you'll get to see a survey. Let us know your feedbacks about the session, and also if you have any topics you would like us to take up in our upcoming Tech Tuesdays, let us know through that survey. Over to you, Nader.
Hi, can you hear me, Vinda? I was talking on mute, I guess.
Oh, I can hear you now.
Yes, yes, yeah. Yeah, I was, sorry, my bad. Yeah, so I mean, actually, I got a question from Venkta. He's asking, can we share the sample files and mapping to practice? So, Venkta, to answer your question, as of now, we don't have any place where I can put these demo files and the mappings. So, what I would request you to go through this demo once again, and I also shared the ISD guide in one of your answers already, right? So, just refer that guide and this demo, and you'll be able to build ISD sample code by your own. And as and when if you see any problem, you can go to the network.informatica.com. You can refer the discussions. And also, if you are using ISCS box at your end, you can create GCS case for any further help in your implementation. So this is one of the question I got from Venkat. Another question I got from another question I got from Dom is regarding the XSPM port. So so basically, as part of the demonstration, Dom, I didn't imported any server files in it. I basically refer one XSD schema file, and that file I leveraged to create the ISM model. And to validate the output corresponding to the same XSD file, I also created one XML file to validate the relational output. So I believe Swagger or the JSON I didn't showcase as part of the XSD import. So I hope this answers your question, Dom. And basically, I received multiple questions on the XSD input, so that's why I covered how we can create XSD in IS XSD based model, because it's a two-step process as of now. So I have got another question from Venkat regarding. Sure, Venkat, I'm. I will be responding to your question in the chat window. If you can see the link for the ISD guide. Please confirm once again, Venkat, if you can, if you are able to open that link and you are able to see the ISD guide for ISD. Any other questions?
Thank you, Nalin.
Apart from that,
please.
I just last point I want to cover on the question from Ankush. He asked, can we use this ISD component in real-time integration? So for that, basically, as of now, we have ISD support with CDI service, which is not the real-time integration service in Informatica. So you can as of now, there is no real-time integration we can leverage on ISD component. But if there is a need in which you need to process real-time data from multiple APIs, and there is a possibility we can enforce any sort of batch in between, then you can create ISD component in CDI, and then you can call that CDI asset in your CI process. So that is one of the option available. But if you would ask me, out of the box, ISD component support in CI, it's not there. And Venkat, I think if you're not able to see my responses on the link, no worries. The moment you will be able to download the PPT from this session, in that I captured a reference section in which also I have plugged in those reference URL. So no worries. The moment you will be able to download the PPT from this session, you are good. You will be having the ISD guide for sure. Licensing, I believe additional license is required, but as of now, Informatica is working in different pricing models. So you need to check with your account manager whether it is enabled, whether this component is enabled as part of your subscription or not. But yeah, it's a license-based subscription component. I think we are good. I don't have any other question in the Q&A box. Yeah.
Yeah. I guess we have answered most of the questions, Nalin. Let's wait for a few more minutes, and if you do not have any questions, let's wind this up.
Sure, Inda.
Everyone, if you have any questions, please post them in the Q&A box. We'll wait for some more time to answer your queries and doubts. Yeah, looks like we have answered most of the questions that came in. Hope we have answered all your questions. If we haven't answered any of the questions, if we failed to answer any of the questions, we'll get back to you after the session. Just now, we have received another question from Ash Nalin. Can we answer that?
Yes, sure, Inda. So Ash, yes, as of now, if you'll see, ISD components is highly dependent on the structure parser transformation, and the transformation need to be connected to one of your source transformation in which you are calling either a Hive connection as a source connection or any flat file connection. So there is no need, you need to host the IST related sample file or the data files to be on the same agent machine. You can leverage a file connection to read data from different files, and you can use your local machine to build the ISD model, because the moment you are creating the ISD component, there is no need to provide any ICS connection details. It's just a drag and drop sort of feature. So even you can use your local machine to build the ISD, Ash.
Thank you, Nalin. So as I was saying, if we have failed to answer any of your questions, we'll get back to you after this session. Thanks everyone for joining. Thank you all the presenters and panelists who have set aside some time for this wonderful session. Thank you. See you on our next Tech Tuesdays. Bye.